That was a tune called New Crossroad Blues. Back in the 1930s, Robert Johnson, the blues guitarist, wrote Crossroad Blues. The crossroads is a big mythological feature in the history of the blues. And it is the point of intersection, it's the point where things meet, and jazz has an extraordinary habit of crossing over with other musical forms and absorbing them and still making it jazz language, whether that's Afro-Cuban music or rock music or ragtime or whatever it is that it sort of comes along, it just absorbs it. So our concert theme for our little part of the concert has been about the crossroads, and that of course is our crossroads where we meet each other and we also meet our fantastic and inspirational colleagues from Jazz at Lincoln Center, who will be with us very shortly. I'm going to hand over to Ed Puddick, who's going to just tell you a tiny bit about walking and swinging.
Good evening. Yes, thanks, Paul. My job with these guys was I was a bit unsure about it when I first arrived at the first rehearsal. And then I soon realised that actually my job was going to be very, very easy. All I needed to do was to introduce these fantastic young musicians to some music that they had never heard or seen before, and to try and get them to approach that music in the same enthusiastic way that they approach everything else that they do. And I don't know if I've been successful in encouraging them to do that, and we're going to find out this evening, aren't we?
Yeah.
Yes, right. Okay, we're going to start off with a fantastic Mary Lou Williams composition. This is called Walking and Swimming.
But before I do that, could we please welcome to the stage from New Jersey, Mr. Terrell Stafford. Thank you.
teachers. I think these teachers and directors deserve a nice round of applause. But also, this music was very much about the blues, about grooving, about improvisation. So we're going to try to capture some of that spirit with Vine Street Rumble.
Thank you.
Mr. Dr. Reginald Thomas, could you come and rejoin us for Little Duke Ellington for the end?
To do what musicians love to do best, which is just get together and play a tune. And Duke Ellington wrote this tune. They called it Jive Jam. And it's literally just for people to join in on and have a great time. So we're going to play Jive Jam to finish the first half of today's concert. Thank you very much for listening. We're going to hear from Reggie and Tara, I hope. But we're going to start off with some guitar. Okay, so this is Jive Jam. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of myself and Paul, I'd like to thank Reg and Terry and John and everyone else who's helped us with this project, but particularly another huge round of applause for the members of the East London Creative Jazz Orchestra.